Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So guys, as usual, I have brought to you this video. The PDF is downloadable via the Telegram channel of ours. The link of the Telegram channel is in description below. So let's begin with the first question. What is the venue of the first World T20 Cricket Championship? Here the right answer is option A, Kerala. So exact location is Thiruvananthapuram and Kerala is the state that is going to host the first World T20 Cricket Championship in the world. Now the All India Sports Council for the of the deaf is the national level agency that governs the sports for the deaf people in India, whereas International Committee of Sports for the Deaf is the international governing body for the sports of the deaf people. Now, this Indian body has received the approval from the International Committee to conduct this world's first Deaf T20 Cricket Championship. I have already told you the venue, but when will it be conducted? So, 2023, guys, is the year in which this championship will be held, and a total of 8 countries, basically minimum requirement is 8 countries need to participate in this championship. Now, apart from this, the fact that you need to memorize from this news is the headquarters of this International Committee of Sports for the Deaf, that is Maryland, USA. Okay, so that is enough from the exam perspective. Moving ahead, which state is running the Project Parvarish? So here the right answer is option B, Assam. Now recently this project has received the Scotch Award for its work. Now what is the work? What is the purpose of this Project Parvarish? So this Project Parvarish was launched to fight malnutrition in the state, and the state is Assam, I have already told you. Now the targeted children age from 6 months to 5 years. Okay, so this is the target audience or population of this Project Parvarish. Now guys, you must come across this Scotch Award many a times in the news, or if you are a daily follower of the Spotlight magazine, then it comes okay more often in the news that this organization, this award, this organization, this project, this institution, this PSU has got this Scotch Award. So what this Scotch Award exactly? So this Scotch Award, first of all, is given by an NGO, a Scotch Foundation, and this was instituted in 2003. Now this award is given to people, given to institutions, given to projects for doing excellent work towards making India a better nation. Okay, so any project that is helping in any sector, that project will be awarded a Scotch Award if it is helping India in becoming a better nation. So that's the whole purpose. Now this Project Parvarish, the Project Parvarish was launched in the Nutrition Month in 2020 in Assam, okay, which is also known as the Poshan Mah. Can you guys tell me which month is celebrated as the Poshan Mah in India? Okay, moving ahead to the third question, what is the limit of transactions per customer in the Aadhaar enabled payment systems? So guys, here the right answer is 5. So this limit of 5 transactions per customer is for 1 month. In 1 month, a customer can do 5 transactions. So first of all, the very basic thing that you need to know about this news entirely is the organization or the regulator that has set this limit. So is it RBI or is it SEBI? None of them. It is NPCI, National Payment Corporation of India, has set up this limit for Aadhaar enabled payment systems. Now, before moving into the details, I want to tell you what this AEPS actually, okay? So guys, as you can see clearly here, the basic purpose of the Aadhaar enabled payment services was to make the people living in the rural areas, was to give them an opportunity to conduct their transactions digitally, okay, by using this micro ATM. So we all know that the people living in the rural areas, that too to the remotest areas, they are not able to use this micro ATM. Therefore, the banks appoint a business correspondent to use this ATM on behalf of the customers. Okay, so suppose this is the woman living in the remotest area and she needs to withdraw her cash from her bank account. Okay, now she does not need to go to the bank branch, she can go to her nearby business correspondent. He will ask for her Aadhaar number, the type of transaction, the name of the bank, the amount which she wants to withdraw, and then this business correspondent will do the biometric authentication of the person, whether the person is authenticated or the right owner of the account or not, okay, by using the fingerprint, okay, fingerprint of this lady as well as the iris detection. Similarly, that is happened in the Aadhaar, okay, the biometric authentication that happens in Aadhaar, the similar procedure is being followed by the business correspondent at the time of doing transactions for the rural people by using the micro ATM. Okay, now what kind of transactions are these people able to do via this micro ATM? Cash withdrawal, cash deposit, asking for the mini statement of their bank account, or they can also do the transfer of funds by this micro ATM. Now, all the functions are very similar to a debit card. Okay, so this, however, the basic difference here is that the Aadhaar number is being used to make the fund transfer, to deposit the money, to withdraw the money, to ask for the balance inquiry. Now, this person can enter her Aadhaar number to make the fund transfer by using the Aadhaar number of the other party also. Okay, and the amount will be cut from her bank account that is linked with her Aadhaar number and will be transferred to the other person's bank account that is linked with his or her Aadhaar number. So this is how the Aadhaar will be used to make the fund transfer. It is not possible for every person to have a debit or credit card, but yes, it is nowadays possible for every Indian to have an Aadhaar card. So this was made in order to make the digital financial services available to the people living in the remotest areas of India as well. And you will be glad to know that this entire system has been adopted and cherished well in the remotest areas as well. People are using this system as well. Now, in order to standardize the number of transactions that a person can do by using the micro ATM in a month has been limited to 5. Okay. So this is the maximum number of transactions. After doing these numbers of transactions, it is the prerogative of the banks that they want to either levy a charge on the customers for doing more transactions, or they want to deny the customers for the more transactions. Okay. Next is that number of transactions has been fixed. The minimum number for which the person can see the mini statements of his or her account through this micro ATM is also again limited. Okay, and that limit is 5. Next, here the third limit that you need to know is that per transaction, the maximum amount that can be withdrawn from this micro ATM is ₹10,000. Now, this is per transaction, guys. Okay, so in one transaction the person can withdraw 10,000, and the maximum number of transactions that are allowed to a customer is 5. So in a month, 50,000 rupees can be withdrawn by a person by using the Aadhaar enabled payment services. So these are all the new transaction limits, new limits that are set by the NPCI. Okay, now let's go into the other details that are left from this news. Okay, first of all, these guidelines need to be implemented by January 15, 2022. And this I have already told you, the number of transactions, the number of mini statement transactions. Now, the thing that I did not explain earlier is the two-factor authentication that has been imposed, or we can say made mandatory by the NPCI for the business correspondents. So far, we have talked about the transactions or the limits that were set for the customers. Now, there is a rule that is set for the business correspondent as well. And that rule is related to the login. Whenever this person has to log in the micro ATM, he or she has to do the biometric authentication once in a day, okay, at the time of login. And in case this person changes and the bank appoints a new business correspondent, then again the biometric authentication becomes all the more important and necessary at the same time. So that's the additional factor information authentication that NPCI has made mandatory for the business correspondents. Next is this cash withdrawal limit that I have told you. Now, I already told you that these transactions have become so popular. Now, this is the proof of the popularity of these AEPS transactions. So, 9.6 crore transactions worth rupees 25,000 crores, over 25,000 crores took place through AEPS in December 2021. Guys, this data is important because your exam is in February. Okay, and we have seen that such minute data, such insignificant data are also asked by the examiners in your examinations. Therefore, this is important. So, do remember this thing. Even if it is able to give you one mark, that is also worth remembering it. Okay. Now, here in this slide, I have explained what the Aadhaar enabled payment system is. So, everything that I told you in the beginning of this question, in the beginning of this explanation, is written here in words. So that if you will forget the explanation, you will have it in words. So, you can just go through it again. Now, here you will see the services that NPCI offer. UPI is also handled by NPCI. RuPay card is handled by. Then this USSD that allows the feature phones to use these services like UPI. Then this national financial switch. Then this Aadhaar enabled payment service, the national automated clearance house, IMPS. So all of these services are provided by NPCI. Now here, the most important thing that you need to understand is that RTGS and NEFT are the two services handled by or regulated by RBI. Okay, governed by RBI basically, and only IMPS is the fund transfer service given by NPCI. I hope that you will keep this thing in your mind. Moving ahead, how many countries have joined the treaty on the non-proliferation of nuclear weapon? So here the right answer is 191. So this is short formed as NPT. Now why is this treaty in the news? So recently five nuclear powered countries have pledged to prevent the proliferation of nuclear weapons and nuclear war, basically prevent nuclear war from happening. Okay, so these five countries are China, France, Russia, UK and US, basically the five members of the UNSC, permanent members of the United Nations Security Council. Now discussing more about this treaty itself, so it is an international treaty that aims to stop the proliferation of nuclear weapons. It also aims at disarmament of the countries, okay, that have the nuclear weapons at present. Now the facts related to the NPT that you need to know from the exam point of view are the dates, okay. So first date is the signatory date or the date on which this treaty was opened for signature by the country. So it is 1968. 1970 is the year in which this treaty was implemented, okay. It came into force. A total of 191 states have signed this, joined this treaty, and 5 nuclear weapon states have also joined this treaty. Now, these five nuclear weapon states are US, UK, France, Russia and China. All of these are the permanent five countries of the UNSC. Now, the countries that have not joined the NPT are India, Pakistan, Israel and North Korea. So, these four countries have refrained from joining this NPT. Now, guys, here is the map that shows all the 9 nuclear powered nations in the map. Okay. Next question is, which state has won the Village of the Year at the 5th edition of International Crafts Award? So guys, here the right answer is option A, Kerala. So 5th edition of the International Crafts Awards were announced, and here is the list of the different categories in which awards were given. Now guys, let me inform you that there were many categories in which the International Crafts Awards were given, but I have chosen the most important categories here. But you need not to worry about it because I have given you the link as well. If you want to go through the entire list, you can also go through the list, but it is needless, guys, because in my opinion the categories that were important are mentioned here and in your Spotlight magazine also. Okay, so the first category here is the Crafts Icon of the Year that has been given to Chandramali Lianage from Sri Lanka. Village of the Year has been given to Kerala Arts and Crafts Village. Lifetime Achievement for Contribution to the Sustainable Development of Craft Sector and Social Inclusion has been given to the Malaysian Prison Department from Malaysia. Master Artisan of the Year Female goes to Amita Sachdev from India. Master Artisan of the Year Male goes to Mubarak Khatri, India. Okay. Now, this International Crafts Award was instituted in the year 2017, and by the name itself, it is evident that is to honor the people engaged in the crafts industries. Okay, so masters of the craft, artists, designer, individuals, institutions, councils, organizations, governments from around the globe are awarded the International Crafts Awards in different categories. Okay, it is given by the Craft Village organization, which is based in New Delhi only. Okay, do remember this thing as well. Next question is, who has been appointed as the Vice President of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank? So here the right answer is Urjit Patel. He has been appointed as a Vice President of AIIB, and the president is Jin Liquin, who is from China. Okay, now do remember this thing that Urjit Patel served as the 24th governor of RBI. So that's all about this entire news. Guys, can you tell me the headquarters of AIIB? Where is the headquarters located? So this is another question for you for today. On that note, I am going to end this session. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. If you like it, then do not forget to subscribe the channel. Hit the bell notification. You can also like this video and share it among your friends as well. Thank you so much for watching the video.